Ahoy there, YouTube! I'm back again today for another game review. Today I'm very excited to check out Inner Circle from Milton Bradley. This is for 2-4 players, ages 8+. It'll take you about 15 to 25 minutes to play. And in Inner Circle, you're going to be moving your little pieces around this board. It's a memory/player elimination game where you're going to be moving your pieces around the board, trying to get your pieces into these inner circles that are going to be on each board. Once all those inner circles are filled, you're physically going to remove a layer of the board, also eliminating a bunch of your pawns, and then do it again 3 more times until you have only one survivor left. What am I talking about? It's old school, but it's a good school. And is good school even a phrase that makes sense? I don't know. Let's open it up and find out.
Alrighty then, we're going to take a look at what you're going to get inside of Inner Circle. So first and foremost, we have our handy dandy back of the rule box. It's pretty clear, pretty concise. It's not a very difficult game, and the box teaches you how to play pretty well. So big thumbs up on the rule box. So in Inner Circle, what you're going to be doing is you're going to try to make it to these inner circles that are the little impressed ones right there. If you're able to do that, then your pieces will survive until the next round, in which you'll do the exact same thing, and then you'll survive to the next round, and you're going to do that until there's only one survivor left. What am I talking about? How does it work? Let's show you the components. Let's get into the gameplay. So component-wise, I've got it set up for a 4-player game. I will say that there are more pieces that are included with the game if you play 2 or 3-player versions of the game. Now, when you set up the game, you're going to have 4 of these little cardboard pieces right here, starting with the smallest one on the bottom, making your way up to the biggest one. And on these circles, you're going to notice that there are little dots, little pips, and those pips are going to tell you how much your piece is going to move. So when you're first placing, when you're first starting the game, everyone is going to take turns putting their pieces all around the board here, trying to remember which pieces have which numbers underneath. And then you start the game going in a clockwise fashion. Player A is going to move one of his pieces. So we'll say that that's blue, and he's got a 3 down here, so he can move his piece in any direction 3 spaces. Now, before you look at how many spaces you're going to move, you have to say which direction you're going to go, because memory is a big element of this game. So I actually just cheated right there by saying it was 3. What I should have done first was saying, I'm going to go this way. And then I'd be like, oh, it's a 3. 1, 2, 3. That was great for me. Now this guy is locked into place. He is going to survive until the next round. So let's say yellow's next, and he says, all right, I'm going to move this piece that way. And it would go 1 space, and then it might go to red. And red's like, all right, I'm going to move this piece this way. And 1, that's locked into place. And then go to green, and green's going to go that way. And it's 1, 2. So green's locked into place. And you're going to continue to do this. Now, once you're locked into place into one of these inner circles, you can't move that piece anymore. Your goal is just to get your other pieces into the circle. So let's just speed this up. And let's say yellow gets there, blue there, red there, green there. Black is also a special one. If you land on the black space in the middle, you can go 1, 2, 3, or 4. So pretty much most of the time, if you can get to the middle, it's going to give you it's going to give you something in the inner circle, the next round, I should say. So now that all the circles are filled in, we carefully lift the board like so. Yeah, it's really kind of cool there. And now we're ready for the next round. And once again, the next round works the same way. So blue would start, then yellow, then red, then green. And as you can see, you could potentially get eliminated in this game. So let's just say green does this, and yellow's right there, and then red and red. Well, blue, unfortunately, would be eliminated from the game for the next round. And then you keep doing this until you get to the final round. And during the final round, there'll only be 3 pieces, and there'll only be 1 circular spot. The first person to get to that circular spot will win the game, and they'll be the winner of Inner Circle. It also has a little nice spot where you can store all the pieces, which is pretty nifty as well. But that, in a nutshell, is what you're going to do inside of Inner Circle. Alrighty then, Inner Circle from Milton Bradley. What are my final thoughts? Let's go over the pros, let's go over the cons. First, on the cons side, game's not going to be for everybody for a variety of different reasons. First and foremost, 2-4 players, restricted player count. Also, this is a very light, family weight, abstract strategy game. And a lot of those words are going to turn off a lot of people. I would also argue that this is a children's game. If you have older kids, I think a 7, 8, 9, 10-year-old could play this no problem by themselves once they know how to play the game, because it is such a simplistic game. It's just, I'm moving this way. How many pieces am I moving? How many pips there are? If you can count to 4 and you know your directions, or at least can point your directions, you can play this game.
Another big con that I have of this game, and this is probably the biggest con that I have of this game, is that I played this now, I think, 4 times, and each time I've enjoyed the first 3 rounds. The first 3 rounds are really stinking cool. They're interesting. It's like, oh, we're fighting survival. I want to get my pieces in there so I can move on to the next round so I'll have a chance at the end. And then you get to the 4th round, and it just becomes, okay, I need to go this way, then this way, then that way. So I don't know. I need to go here, there, and then there. That's my 3 turns. That's the 3 ways I can get there. And then it just becomes, who can figure out how to get in the middle the quickest? Not in a fun way, like, oh, let's see, am I just randomly... I don't know how to explain it. It just then becomes not a fun game for me. And the kids agreed with me as well. I played this in my classroom with a bunch of kids, and they all really enjoyed the game at the start. The first 3 rounds are fun. They're exciting. They're tense. You don't want to get locked out. You don't want to get eliminated. Then the 4th round, it's just like, all right, I have to go 3 up, and then I have to go 2 northeast, and then I have to go 1 this way, and then 2 that way, and boom, we'll be in. And it's just who can figure out how to get in there the fastest. That's really what it is. And I guess it is like that on the first 3 rounds, but the first 3 rounds are fun, and that 4th round just fell flat. It's hard for me to explain why, but it did. Also, I like this best at the higher player counts. 2 players was not that much fun. 3 players was better. 4 players was best. 4 is definitely the sweet spot for this game. It just has more interaction. More people like vying for those spots. It's just more fun, in my personal opinion. Moving on to the pros, Inner Circle is an okay to good game. That's it. That's all I can say about this game. That is the best, most glowing recommendation. Slap it on the box if they ever reprint it. Inner Circle, it's okay to good. So what do I like about the game? So first and foremost, it's a cool premise. It is. You know, I really like how you're trying to fight for survival and get to those circles. And despite the fact there is no theme, you know, we kind of made up a theme as we're going. It's like, oh my gosh, we're rabbits and we have to get in the holes before it starts to, the flood comes. That was the theme that the one girl came up with. That we're rabbits all trying to get to our little rabbit holes before the flood comes and murders us all and drowns us all. Kind of a dark theme, but it was cool. She came up with it. It was creatively, and we were playing around like hop, hop, hop. We were playing pretend like we had little buddies. It worked, okay? I liked it. The kids liked it. Then once we get to that 4th round, it's just bleh. And the other thing is, another big problem I have with that 4th round is this is where younger kids are immediately going to get crushed. Because I did. I played this with my son, a 5-year-old in my class, and he liked it. But then he got to that 4th round and he had no shot. He's just been randomly moving here and there and getting lucky. And you can do that the first 3 rounds. But that 4th round, you can't do that. You're not just going to stumble into the middle circle. And we're talking about pros. So also, you know, component-wise, it looks cool. The little board is nice and sturdy, and it works really well. The inner circle piece, where you lift it up and all the pieces that are eliminated go away, that really works pretty well. The box insert is good. Rules are well done. It's just the game itself is okay to good, and the 4th act of this game ruins this game for me. I could have told you this was a good to great abstract strategy game if you had 3 or 4 players, but unfortunately, the 4th round of the game nix that. So in the end, Inner Circle, there's a reason why you've probably never heard of it. There's a reason, as I always say, why this game has gotten lost to the wasteland of time and not getting reprinted, and that's because 75% of the game is great, and 25% of the game is not that much fun. If you enjoyed this video, please try to click on that subscribe button down below in the comments below. Let me know, what's another game out there that you really like all the elements of the game except for one? For me personally, it is... You know, this is kind of a double-edged sword here. For me personally, it's Werewolf. I love Werewolf. I absolutely adore Werewolf. But being eliminated from Werewolf, potentially for hours, if you're playing with a larger group, is not fun. But that's part of the reason why I love all the other elements so much, is because there's such a sense of tension knowing that if you're eliminated, it's not like, oh, I lost a life. Oh, I lost a coin. It's like, oh, I'm done. I can't talk to the group anymore. I'm out of the village. And I feel like, despite the fact I don't like the mechanism of getting eliminated, it adds to the tension of the game, so it actually is a good thing. But let me know in the comments below, what is a game that you enjoy that has one mechanism or one aspect that you don't like? And as always, thanks for your time, YouTube.